The color is beautiful.
Welcome to Unboxing China. I'm Nancy, and joining me today is my guest host for today.
I'm Igor. Hey, what's up, everyone?
So we are in Nanyang in Henan province, and Igor, I will introduce you to something really precious, especially for us Chinese.
I'm really excited. Check it out. Ooh, we've got some jade here, everyone.
Yes, and you know, actually, I got more on me.
Oh! How come you got so much?
Yes, because we are in this town that hosts one of the biggest jade markets in China.
Chinese people really love jade.
Yes, exactly. Yeah. And that's why I have one for myself. And also, I have some jade stuff here.
So you have enough, but I don't have any. So yes. I really want to go to the market and check it out.
Of course. So let's go.
Yeah, let's go, guys. Well, look at those, like hundreds of umbrellas.
That is the market. Oh! So it is the morning market, and I think it actually starts at 6:30 or something.
That is so cool. I've noticed there are the cars from different provinces.
Yes, it's one of the biggest wholesale markets, which means that people come in for like mass amount of these stuff.
So they buy like cheaper by the dozen.
Right, so see, they come in piles.
These are beautiful. Just look at that golden color.
It's So
it's all natural.
You're falling in love, is it?
Falling in love. I also noticed that there are a lot of people holding their phones.
Yes, I think they are doing live streams.
They're like selling these.
Right, and they really know the stuff. They know where they can get the good stuff. If they really say, okay, I probably want that type of thing, and my budget is like 500 kuai, and they will go to this market and get us some of them.
That's really interesting.
It's already time for them to wrap up for this morning market. Oh. And they are our bigger markets on the other side of the town.
A lot of people here.
It's very crowded.
Hustle and bustle. Everybody is up for buying some good jade. You know, when we think about jade, it was always that jade, we say jade color, like the green color, like this. Okay. Then today, like I saw, you know, jade of being so many colors.
Right, see, even in terms of green, we have darker green, and then lighter green.
So when you look at it like this, then you can see, you can actually tell if there's texture inside.
Right, right. And you look like a 带货主播.
Like this, you can't see anything.
I think you are becoming an expert.
Yeah. I've noticed Chinese young people, they like wearing jade.
We think they are pretty, of course. And also, I think it has some history, it has some culture in it.
I couldn't imagine that would be so big. Just look how many shops there are.
Right,
so it pretty much like proves that Chinese people really love jade.
I think you can honestly spend the whole day inside this place to find your piece of jade.
Like a month for sure.
Right.
有将近两万户，在这个石佛寺形成了十个大型的玉雕专业市场，这样的摊位呢和门店呢将近四万个。
所以我们今天看到的还是冰山一角，
我好奇为什么就偏是这个地方会规模最大。它有历史上的原因，镇平玉雕加工的历史呢是比较悠久，据我们考证呢是始于石器时代，成于夏商，兴于汉唐，精于明清。 聚集呢已经有7000多年的历史，还有呢就是我们这边呢有一个母亲河，赵河，上游呢盛产朱砂，在琢玉啊、雕玉的时候呢，它是都可以用得到的。玉雕市场上呢，这个玉雕的品种呢是非常丰富的，凡是世界上发现的优质玉料呢，在这儿都可以看得到。有句话呢叫千般玛瑙万般玉，像我们中国四大名玉里边的和田玉啊。 独山玉啊、秀玉啊、蓝田玉啊，都是老百姓们非常喜欢的这一些玉种。说起这个独山玉，它是咱们南阳特有的玉，它有什么样的特点？独山玉呢，最大的特点呢，就是颜色比较丰富，主要有7种颜色，加上过渡色呢，是有100多种，那种赏心悦目的这种感觉呢，非常强，非常适合做这个俏色工艺品。
We can see the artist really used the color really well.
Yes, I know. It like used the original pattern of the jade. And like on top of that, he's thinking, oh, this color, I'll use it for a flower.
Right.
This one for the mountain.
我也经常跟我的徒弟们去说, 我们要学会玉雕, 而不是学会雕玉。每一个料子过来, 你会根据它的料子的不同, 去挖掘他自身的美，去挖掘他自身想表达的语言，帮他去叙述了。我觉得这是在做玉雕，我们的玉文化是没有断过的，最早它就是祭祀品啊，一种可以和神仙对话的一种媒介，让它去承载其他材质承载不了的东西。一块玉玺，它是一个国家的权力的象征，玉它最大的核心就是它的真善美，它是一个很好的一份传承。贵的玉，便宜的玉，我们买回来它就变得很有意思，
在你手里就是有价值了、
对，它会见证一些，
包括我们日常生活中很多用语啊，我们的成语啊，就王字偏旁的很多很多字，其实它都是从玉的这个含义里面来的。
取一个字，宝贝的宝，宝盖头它其实就是家嘛，
家里面有玉
就是宝贝，所以从玉上面啊、你们会更容易获得我们中国人他内心深处的一些寄托。
You know, you go after this visit, I'm still totally in awe.
Me too. Like, I'm so impressed. Because originally I thought jade was pretty much just green.
Right.
But then I realized that it's got such a great variety of colors. Mm-hmm. I really love the part when we learned about the history. Mm-hmm. And I realized that jade was such an important part in Chinese culture.
And now you get why I have this and this on me.
Right.
So on a scale of 1 through 10, how much would you recommend this place?
I would totally recommend it. Because there are so many markets, all kinds of gems and stones and everything. So if you're for these things, you have to come here.
Yeah, they said there are 10 markets. We just visited one. So definitely you can spend more time here. And I guess that's all for today's Unboxing China. Thanks, Diego, for joining me.
Yes, thanks for having me.
We will see you next time. Bye-bye.
See you guys.